days, it's all about viewing on the go, right? Whether you're stuck in traffic, watching a movie that's playing in the SUV in front of you, or catching a flick on your phone. It seems like if you can't put it in your pocket or under your airplane seat, then it's not worth it. But come on.
IMAX was derived from the words maximum image, and you might be tempted to call it maxi, but that doesn't begin to capture the immersive experience of watching eye-popping 3D docs or major Hollywood flicks in a theater like this.
So now I'm here with Greg Foster. He's the president of IMAX Filmed Entertainment.
This is the man who decides what gets shot and what gets shown in IMAX.
IMAX is about scope. IMAX is about transporting you into this immersive world.
A typical IMAX screen is 52 by 72 feet, way larger than normal movie screens. It's also placed closer to the audience and is slightly curved. That means the images on screen completely fill your field of vision. Add in stadium seating so you don't have to worry about big dude right in front of me syndrome, and up to 18,000 watts of digital surround sound, and you are ready for a primo movie-going experience.
When filmmakers make a movie, they're not usually making the movie for a small 40-inch television screen. They're making the movie for, if they can, their imagination, for a 70-foot-wide screen.
But how do you fill that screen with a crystal-clear image?
David Keeley.
Gnar.
What's up, man?
David is the head of post-production, and he is impervious to cold.
Why is it so cold in here?
Well, it's to keep the film good for a long period of time.
So, David, I take it this is the first step in converting a conventional film into an IMAX film, right?
What we're doing here, we have a 35-millimeter scanner and a 65-millimeter scanner. And what we're doing is taking the analog film and putting it in the digital domain, making it into ones and zeros. And basically, there's a lens here, and there's a light source, and it's scanning, you know, pixel for pixel as that moves along.
This process involves scanning the whole movie, one single frame at a time.
So it takes a good long time and
so
film.
So for one movie, how long?
Well, I mean, you know, we could be scanning here literally for months sometimes.
So where does it go, to a server?
We have 100 terabytes of storage. That's where it's going now, through fiber optics into our storage area network to get ready for us to do the next process, which will be dust busting.
Yep, he just said dust busting. But it's not like cleaning the chip crumbs out of your couch.
So if there is dirt in the scan, then you have to what's called dust bust and get that dirt out by a process by just looking at every frame and say, oh, there's a piece of dirt, and then you have a computer program to replace those pixels. And then it goes to the next process, the DMR, the digital remastering process, up in Toronto.
Then it gets sent back here for final quality control and transformation into a film print or a digital projection format.
Now, you've gone through the DMR process, you've finalized the color corrections, and now what?
Well, now you go into a process where you package it. You make the DCP.
The DCP is the digital cinema package. Basically, the whole movie on this little guy.
The hard drive goes in just a little case like this.
Can I plug the hard drive in now?
Yeah, you can. We'll just show you how you do that.
Awesome.
Here's a USB cable.
Yes.
We'll put it there. And that's all there is to it. Well, it may...
That's it?
Well, that's it. But you know what? It's not instant. This is a 2¾-hour movie. And we'll just plug it in there. And it takes about 2¾ hours to actually ingest it in the projector.
David, now that I've seen what goes into IMAX movies and make them so awesome, I really want to go watch one.
Okay, well, why don't you go down to the theater and I'll power up the system and you'll see IMAX for real.
Yes, thanks, man.
Thanks, man.
Thanks to the specialized technologies developed at IMAX, we can all feel like we are in the movies. Hit me!